friends and colleagues, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we are here in front of European Parliament on the occasion of 22nd October 2021. We warmly welcome all of you on this occasion. We warmly welcome all of you on the occasion of Flag Day, a day when Pakistani Army launched an operation, and that operation named Gulmarg. That operation, supported and funded by Pakistani Army. Why we call this day a black day in the history of Jammu and Kashmir? Because today, as a result of this Gulmarg operation, our people have suffered a lot. They have kidnapped our women. They have killed our people. They have killed our children. They killed our women. They killed our men, irrespective of their caste, their color, creed, and gender. So I would like to invite speakers. First of all, I would like to invite Andy Vermouth from Belgium, and he is an activist and president of an NGO, a human rights organization. Andy Vermouth, floor is yours.
Like this.
Yes. Welcome, everybody. Very nice summit.
Let's start.
Assalam alaikum, namaskar, hello, adab. I'm here today as a human rights defender for Kashmir, among the people of Kashmir, and for the people of Kashmir, believing in a reality of a unified, peaceful Kashmir with the Kashmiris and for the Kashmiris. That Kashmir may one day become one territory, with unity, freedom, and justice for all who live there. Kashmir, Chichuk, Mian, Yigur. Kashmir, I love you. Hello, everybody. My name is Andy Vermouth. Macho now, Andy Vermouth. I'm here today in my position as a human rights defender for the International Alliance for the Defense of Rights and Freedoms, consulted by the United Nations and President of the Fundamental Rights Organization, Post Versa. Thank you for the invitation. It's not obvious for me to stand here today. I have gone through quite an evolution in my thinking about Kashmir, and United Kashmir is ultimately a noble act and very likely the only solution to end the conflicts. This will require a revolution, and I'm advocating today for a non-violent revolution in this. Kashmir, Chechuk, Myon Yigur, Kashmir, I love you. Je crois en un Kashmir où tous les peuples vivent en liberté, en unité, les uns avec les autres et en paix, avec une dame justice juste. On doit créer un espace en Kashmir de paix, de la justice et de l'unité. Because I want to outline some objective facts today. The neighboring country coordinated an attack with the help of Pashtun tribes that are driven mainly by a military country in 1947. This attack has isolated the whole of Kashmir, and the people of Kashmir are the overcomers of this delicate antagonism in Kashmir starting in 1947. Kashmir, Chechuk, Myon, Yigur. Kashmir, I love you. As an international human rights organization, we with the International Alliance for the Defense of Rights and Freedom rejects any course of action using religion as a weapon for its fundamental plans and interests in the Kashmiri region. People should be united by their common culture, and unity and diversity should be the motto of every reunification process. And a common constitution made by the people, for the people, can play an important role in a peaceful solution for the Kashmiri region. And it's beautiful to see today UKPNP serenely mentioning the unification of one Kashmir. As a human rights defense organization, we can only support a peaceful and political solution. Kashmir, Chechuk, Myon Yigur. Kashmir, I love you. From 4 October 1947 until 23 October 1947, just 22 days are special days when a free, progressive government detailed by individuals of Kashmir administered over the democratic Kashmir. Since the 24th October 1947, the state is being controlled by neo-radical elements across the truce line, currently called LOC by possessing powers. Kashmir, Chechuk, Myon Yigur, Kashmir, I love you. Yeah, it should be good that everybody.
I love you, Kashmir.
I love you. The historic background of Kashmir shows that for a very long time of history, the state stayed free. During these years, the state thrived as a focal point of progress and rich culture. However, we can clearly say that there was a majority rule system. As we imagine, it wasn't the same. Since in those previous days, outright and genetic rulers dominated. In this way, Kashmir had been no exception. I repeat, I am the promoter. I'm here today as a human rights defender for Kashmir, among the people of Kashmir, and for the people of Kashmir, believing in the reality of a unified, peaceful Kashmir with the Kashmiris and for the Kashmiris. That Kashmir may one day become one territory with unity, freedom, and justice for all who live there. Kashmir, Jai Chuk Manye Guwar, Kashmir. Je crois en un Kashmir où tous les peuples vivent en liberté, en unité, et les uns avec les autres, en paix, avec une dame justice juste. Merci.
Thank you, MD Vermont. Thank you for your participation. Now I would like to call, I would like to invite President Salami, advisor, European People's Party in the European Parliament. President Salami, the floor is yours.
Quality of the President of the Union Association.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you for the invitation. I would like to thank and congratulate UKNP leaders for this amazing demonstration and opportunity to support the Kashmiri people and to have a united Kashmir. Peace in Kashmir. I believe that peace is possible. Peace in Kashmir is a relative term. There is a need to establish peace and dialogue between the different communities in the region for so many reasons. First of all, Kashmir is the greatest source of tension between two nuclear armed rivals. The neighboring countries fought three wars over the region following the suicide attack in Kashmir in 2019. A nuclear war between the neighboring countries would be devastating for both countries. But the indirect effects on climate change would be catastrophic for the Kashmiri people. Kashmiri people suffer from environmental consequences following the nuclear weapons. The reason number two is Afghanistan. A successful withdrawal from Afghanistan also requires peace and stability in Kashmir. The mix of instability of Afghanistan and popular discontent following the uprising of Kashmiri people creates very unstoppable conditions of war. After the state withdrawal from Afghanistan in 1989, the transformation of Afghan war corps from jihad to chaos within the 1990s. Opened an upsurge of violence in Kashmir. I quote Jonah Black. I believe that stabilizing Afghanistan is also resolving the Kashmiri crisis and could be another time trigger for Afghan and international militant relocation to Kashmir.
So that we need a stability and the unity of Kashmir. The reason number three, democracy and human rights. Facilitating Kashmiri peace is a chance for the international community to create democracy and human rights in the region. It might send a message to the neighboring countries, and it is a reminder to the whole international community that the increase of authoritarianism is not the values that we should defend here in Europe and everywhere in the world. We need a global leadership, and this global leadership starts by the current psychological state and women's health crisis is also a reflect in Russia. Kashmiri women suffer from COVID-19 pandemic, but also suffer from psychological trauma following the war and the division. We need to think about Kashmiri women. We need to think about unity and peace. As well, we have peace negotiations, which are fought and which represent the bulk of Kashmiris. We need to listen to these political parties, to these communities in Kashmir who want to be together and who want to be united. Of course, on August 2020, six political parties in Kashmir wanted collectively to create a declaration.
Mr. Sagor.
And to support their voices and to support their efforts to create peace and to create dialogue between the different communities, between the different religions and ethnicities. Kashmiri people deserve peace, and the EU political sphere and international communities as well as international institutions need to listen to the Kashmiri people, need to listen to their voices and support their autonomy and self-determination. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Menal Salami. Dear friends, colleagues, distinguished guests, I would like to give my insight about this whole conspiracy which was orchestrated and implemented on 22nd of October 1947. Initially, there were four characters in this whole conspiracy and invasion. First, a Britisher, George Cunningham. Second, Dean officially. Third one is Major Khurshid Anwar. And the fourth one, who was actually heading this whole Operation Gulmarg, Major General Akbar Khan. So on this day, Pakistan commit atrocities and killed our people. As a result of this Gulmarg operation, our state has been divided since 1947. Our families have been divided since 1947. And everything has been destroyed. Our culture has been destroyed. Our values have been destroyed. Our education system has been destroyed. And we are suffering since 1947. Pakistan is using religion as a weapon and Islam as a foreign policy tool. For example, Pakistan hosted an international terrorist, Osama bin Laden, as a state guest. And American marriage has killed this international terrorist in Abbottabad, a military garrison town. Now I would like to invite Malik Bazai, the PTM leader in Europe. Malik Bazai, sir, the floor is yours.
Thank you, UKPNP, Kenzie Bond, Bari Berbani, and Provoki, and the speech, and the to submission. हम कश्मीर तापस प्रशासन पूरे क्षेत्र में पाकिस्तान अफगानिस्तान और प्रशासन पूरे क्षेत्र में इंसानी हकों के अलग बरदार है वहाँ पे जितने भी जुल्म हो रहे हैं या जिनको डिसअपीयरेंस है या ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेशन है इनके खिलाफ है हम लोग हम मजलूमों के साथ खड़े हैं हम मजलूमों के साथ इस जदोजहद में बराबर के शरीक हैं आज जो कश्मीरी मौजू है उस पर हमारे जो कोलिग्स हैं उन्होंने इंग्लिश में बात की है मैं भी यही कहूँगा कि कश्मीर जो है कश्मीर का जो केस है वो हम लोग बड़े अच्छी तरीके से समझ सकते हैं जो दर्द हम लोग जीतते हैं वही दर्द कश्मीरी भी झेल रहे हैं कश्मीरी भी एक कश्मीर होकर दो हिस्सों में दो मुल्कों के जेर तसल्लुत है और हम पश्तून अफगान भी इसी तरह दो मुल्कों में बटे हुए हैं पाकिस्तान इस बुनियादी जो सूरत हाल है कश्मीर में जम्मू कश्मीर में वहाँ पे ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेशन के हवाले से पाकिस्तानी फौज के जो ऑपरेशन है जो हमारे कोलिग ने जिक्र किया है इन सारे के पीछे जो है वो के पीछे है पाकिस्तान अपने इस्तेमारी पॉलिसियों को आगे ले जाते हुए यहाँ पे खत्ते में जितने भी नेशन है जितने भी कौम है उनके जुल्म के खत्ते में बसने वाले पश्तून हो खत्ते में बसने वाले बलोच हो खत्ते में बसने वाले सिंधी हो खत्ते में बसने वाले कश्मीरी हो अफगान हो इन सारों का जो एक ही दुश्मन है या इन सारों को जो कसा है जिसने वो पाकिस्तान के फौजी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट बलोचिस्तान में सैकड़ों में हजारों की तादाद में लोगों को गायब किया हुआ है बलोचिस्तान में लोगों की सियासी कारकुनों के मशक्शुदा लाशें हर रोज फेंके जाते हैं इसी तरह सिंध में जो कुछ हो रहा है वो किसी से दिखा छुपा नहीं है इसी तरह पश्तूनों के साथ जो हो रहा है वो हमने हर फोरम पे उनका आवाज उठाया हुआ है कि पाकिस्तान फौज ने पश्तून का वतन में 70,000 पश्तूनों को वॉर अगेंस्ट टेररिस्ट के उस हवाले से 70,000 पश्तून किल बाय पाकिस्तानी फौजी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट इसके अलावा हमारे लोगों को पता नहीं है कि हमारे बच्चा जो है वो कहा है पाकिस्तान फौजियों ने उन्हें अगवा किया है आज भी हमारे टीचर के साथी जो है पाकिस्तानी फौज के सलाखों के पीछे जिंदगी गुजार रहे हैं मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट अली वजीर इज स्टिल इन प्रिजन अवेश अख्तर अली पश्तीन और कॉलेज और इन प्रिजन इन पाकिस्तान हमारे सैकड़ों साथी जो है वो पाकिस्तान के जेलों में है हमारे हजारों साथी जो है वो उनको अगवा किया हुआ है जस्टिस में अदालत में नहीं लाया जा रहा है इसी तरह अफगानिस्तान में जो डेवलपमेंट हो रही है उन सारे के पीछे हम ये कहने में हक बजानिब होंगे कि पाकिस्तानी फौजी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट जो है वो तालिबान के मेन सपोर्टर है इस खत्ते में दहशतगर्दी के या दहशतगर्दों के मेन सपोर्टर जो है वो पंजाबी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट है वो पाकिस्तानी एस्टेब्लिशमेंट है वो ISI है ISI तालिबान के सपोर्टर है और तालिबान को उन्होंने ट्रेनिंग दी है ट्रेनिंग दी थी और अब जो है ला के काबल पे बिछाया हुआ है
और काबल में अफगानिस्तान में बेगुनाह लोगों को आज भी कत्लेआम बेगुनाह लोगों की जारी है। यहाँ पे औरत को, यहाँ पे लेडीज को स्कूल जाने की, लड़कियों को स्कूल जाने पर पाबंदी है, वहाँ पे लेडीज को काम करने पर पाबंदी है, वहाँ पे जो जुल्म दिए जा रहे हैं वो काबिले बयान नहीं है। कल एक तो वॉलीबॉल की एक इंटरनेशनल प्लेयर एक लड़की थी, उनको गला काट करके कत्ल कर दिया गया है। इसी हवाले से मैं अपने सारे कॉलेज को जो इमिग्रेंट डिफेंडर है उनको यही बात कहता हूँ कि आइए देख जाइए, एक ऐसे प्रोग्राम तश्कील दिया जाए कि पाकिस्तान जो है स्टेटमेंट का जो बुनियादी वो है कि आप ह्यूमन राइट्स के हवाले से ह्यूमन राइट्स का वो करेंगे।
तहफ़्ज़ करेंगे
ह्यूमन राइट के, तहफ़्ज़ करेंगे, उनके ख्याल रखेंगे। लेकिन पाकिस्तान में बसने वाले सिंधी चिल्ला रहे हैं, पाकिस्तान में बसने वाले पश्तून चिल्ला रहे हैं, पाकिस्तान में सिंधी बसने वाले बलोच और कश्मीरी चिल्ला रहे हैं कि पाकिस्तान जो है हमारी नस्ल कुशी कर रहे हैं। तो हम यूरोपीय पार्लियामेंट पर मुतालिबा करते हैं कि पाकिस्तान का जो जीएसटी पोस्ट स्टेटस है उनसे पाकिस्तान का नाम हटाया जाए। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक यू मलक बाजाई। Without wasting time, now I would like to invite Gary Cartwright, civil society activist and journalist from Great Britain. Gary, floor is yours.
Sajid, thank you very much. First of all, I'd like to congratulate JKIPA and what is again a peaceful and dignified demonstration, bringing together like-minded individuals, people who are committed to the ideals of peace and democracy. And I believe very strongly that there are no greater ideals that any man can serve that are as great as those of peace and democracy. I've been here in Brussels for 17 years, and during that time, I've lost count of the number of protests, demonstrations, conferences, private discussions that I have held with those who are campaigning for the freedom and independence of Kashmir. If it takes another 17 years, then I should still be attending such meetings and events, because I certainly am not going anywhere until this issue that we all care about is indeed resolved. In the world in which we live today, conflict remains too much of the catalyst for progress. I disagree with such sentiments. I believe that peace and democracy are the catalysts for progress. And I will say to you now, until we get what you want, which is a peaceful, unified Kashmir, we are not going anywhere. We're here for you. We always will be. This.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Mr. Kasba. Yes.
Thank you, Gary Cartwright. Now I would like to invite the Honorable Farmer, Member of the European Parliament, MEP, Farmer MEP, Mr. Sagar. Floor is yours.
Thank you. Freedom of speech, freedom of religion. We fully understand you in Kashmir for what are you struggling and fighting. We lost the war. We are living now in 7 different countries. We have behind us a communist regime where we lost our properties and still fighting for them, for our language right. Of course, our struggle cannot be compared with your suffering, but
you have our full solidarity, but this is not enough. The EU should reconsider his relation with Pakistan. If the EU is supporting Pakistan, he should support all citizens of Pakistan. He should reconsider his connection, his relation with Pakistan. There is no, if there is no human rights, if there is no freedom of speech, if there is no religious freedom, then EU should not support those countries, those regimes, like the Pakistani one. I hope that you are not alone in your struggle, and you and we can gain solidarity among the, not just European countries, but all over the world. Once a Hungarian traveler, Dr. Ervin, visited Kashmir, and he wrote a nice book about this. I have this book since my childhood, and the title of the book is The Country of the Happy End. I hope that once Kashmir will be again a happy country, a country of the happy people. I wish you all the best. God bless you.
Thank you. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, MEP, Mr. Sadhguru Bosa. Now I would like to invite the Central Secretary for Foreign Affairs, United Kashmir People National Party, Mr. Jamil Maksud, to come and give insight about the this Gulmarg operation at 22nd October 1947, tribal invasion in Jammu and Kashmir.
Floor is yours.
Congress, respected journalists, former MEP, defenders, and political rights champions, I welcome you in today's demonstration, which is marking the 75th flag day when our state, the state of Jammu and Kashmir, was invaded by Pakistani military. We are suffering since then. Every day we are losing our children, our women, our rights. Our right to life has been compromised since then. Each year we celebrate, we commemorate this flag day to remind the international community and to remind our people that we did not forget what you have inflicted on us 74 years ago. My dear comrades, at the time when the British divided Indian subcontinent into two dominions, the state of Jammu and Kashmir was a free and partially independent country. It was under the suzerainty of the British with the Treaty of Amritsar, 16th of March 1846. The ruler of Jammu and Kashmir was hesitant to join either India or Pakistan because he felt that the Muslims would not feel comfortable while joining India, whereas the non-Muslim state subjects would be uncomfortable with Pakistan. So under those circumstances, he decided to sign a standstill agreement with Pakistan on 8th of August 1947. But Pakistan invaded, disrespecting its commitment to keep its cordial and brotherly relations to the former state of Jammu and Kashmir. So what happened in our part of Kashmir, which is occupied by Pakistan? Very few people have the knowledge of those events, because Pakistan orchestrated militancy in Kashmir Valley, and everybody knows only about Kashmir. But the people of the Jammu region were divided, and the women were kidnapped, and later they were sold in the brothel of Lahore in very little money. The young girls were raped, and their precious ornaments and wealth was stolen. This was what happened in Muzaffarabad, in Ramlakot, in Bagh, in Mirpur, and in other areas adjacent to Pakistan. And many Pakistani tribes, some from Mari and some from Kotli Satya, invaded in our part of Kashmir and killed innocent citizens of the state of Jammu and Kashmir. And many were driven out, and they have been living as a refugees in Indian part of Kashmir, Indian part of Jammu Kashmir, since October 1947. And today, when Pakistan has exposed supporting Talibanization in Afghanistan, Pakistan is equally equipping and providing logistic support to the terrorist organizations like Lashkar-e-Tayyiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed, Harkat-e-Ansar, Tariq-e-Mujahideen, and many others in different shapes, with the different flags, and with the same ideology that you have to kill all the non-Muslims in the region. Today, the same terrorists are target killing Kashmiri teachers, professors, lawyers, judges, human rights activists in all parts of Kashmir, not only in Indian part, but in our part. They have created an environment of harassment, intimidation, and killing. Anyone who is silent is a safe. Anyone who speaks for his human rights, for women rights, for child rights, for health rights, for right to development, is being targeted by these terrorist organizations which are enjoying the blood of Pakistani military and its notorious terrorist ISI. With regard to today's demonstration, I would like to demand European Parliament that at least you should try to ask Pakistan to comply with the recommendations of 24th of May 2007 European Parliament resolutions. Also, Pakistan is not respecting its commitment on GSP plus trade agreement. Pakistan is placed under grey list by the Financial Action Task Force because of its ill intentions in the region. Money laundering, terrorism, religion as a weapon against human rights defender is a popular Pakistani policies and popular Pakistani narrative in the social media and in main electronic and print media today. My dear comrades, today our children are suffering, our women are suffering at the hands of Pakistani military in the border areas. What Pakistan army is doing? They open a fire with Indian troops on the other side of line of control. And when these unarmed and innocent people look after the shelter, they bring them to the military hideouts, and there they mark the younger. And later, they force them to marry. They rape them. They are raping our children. Even when we speak about this, they start a propaganda that these people are working for the international forces. These people are working for Jews, Christians, non-Muslims. No, we are not working for anybody. We are working for our people. We are demanding our human rights. Today, when the United Nations has asked that access to clean drinking water is a fundamental human right, our people are depriving that very basic and fundamental need in our villages. We are deprived of health facilities. Our police is controlled by an officer which is deputed from Islamabad. Our financial administration is controlled by a secretary of finance which is deputed from Pakistan. Our health system is controlled by a secretary which is deputed from Islamabad. Our entire administration is controlled by the general officer commanding sitting in Mary, Pakistan. So he is the powerhouse. He is controlling our money, our development, our medicine, our doctors, our curriculum, everything. Today, the books of our history has been banned. We are not allowed to study our own history. We are not allowed to speak our own language. We are not allowed to celebrate our own customs. Our people are suffering from cultural genocide. We are facing cultural genocide at the hands of Pakistani military. The world should remember. The world should listen. The world should know this fact that the people of Pakistani occupied Kashmir are facing cultural genocide. And we need your support. We need the support from everybody, from Pashtun, from Sindhis, from Baloch, even from moderate, progressive Punjabi intellectuals to come forward and to tell your government to withdraw from Pakistani occupied Kashmir as you committed under the terms of truce agreement 1947. You have to comply with your international obligations as a state party of International Convention on Civil and Political Rights. You have to comply with the recommendations, with the stipulations, with the articles of United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights. We are human beings. We are people. Unfortunately, we fell under your administration. It doesn't mean we do not deserve human rights. We equally deserve human rights as anybody else on this planet Earth. You have to stop exploitation of our natural resources, diverting our rivers, producing electricity, and keeping marginalized our people from these rights. You have to provide them. Once again, I am very thankful to my dear comrades, the journalists, the civil society activists who have joined us in this demonstration today. We hope we will have a great comradeship. We will continue our peaceful struggle for the sake of our people to stop galvanization, to stop extremism, terrorism in our region. This is our commitment to remain steadfast with our ideology of a united state of Jammu and Kashmir, including Gilgit Baltistan, where the people and human rights activists have been placed under Schedule 4. They cannot travel to other city. If they have to go in the other city, in the other village, they have to seek the permission from the local police station. So these draconian laws must be abolished. And the people who do not subscribe the ideology of Kashmir would be Pakistan, should allow to take part in election, should allow to exercise their fundamental political and human rights under your occupation.
Narin.
So thank you once again, and I would say
Narin lagaye na main milwata hu aapke
I would you do it to the Jammu Kashmir. Pakistan
quit Jammu Kashmir.
Quit Jammu Kashmir. Stop terrorism in our region. Stop terrorism. Stop terrorism in our region. Stop Pakistan from using religion as a weapon against women, against children, and against marginalized communities.